thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith: Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it: Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Revive thy church, Lord God of hosts, whensoever it doth fall into complacency and sloth, by raising up devoted leaders like thy servant John Henry Hobart, whom we remember this day, and grant that their faith and vigor of mind may awaken thy people to thy message and their mission. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Epistle of Jude. But you, beloved, build yourselves up on your most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of God. Look forward to the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ that leads to eternal life. Now to him who is able to keep you from falling, and to make you stand without blemish in the presence of his glory and with rejoicing, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, power, and authority before all time, now and forever. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The psalm appointed for today is the 133rd psalm, which is found on page 787 of the Book of Common Prayer, Psalm 133. Oh, how good and pleasant it is when brethren live together in unity. It is like fine oil upon the head that runs down upon the beard of Aaron, and runs down upon the collar of his robe. It is like the dew of Hermon that falls upon the hills of Zion. For there the Lord has ordained the blessing, life forevermore. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. Jesus prayed, Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them in your name that you have given me. I guarded them, and not one of them was lost except the one destined to be lost, so that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you, and I speak these things in the world so that they may have my joy made complete in themselves. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they do not belong to the world,
just as I do not belong to the world. I am not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into the world, so I have sent them into the world. And for their sakes I sanctify myself, so that they also may be sanctified in truth. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you be to thee, O Christ. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Today we celebrate the feast of John Henry Hobart. Hobart was born in Philadelphia in 1775, and he went to the University of Pennsylvania before transferring to Princeton, but he's not primarily known as a Philadelphian. He's primarily known as a New Yorker, where he was one of the founders of the General Theological Seminary, my seminary. When I was in seminary for the last year or two, the portrait of Hobart hung above my mantle in my rooms in seminary, and so I have a special affinity for him. In that portrait, he bears a striking resemblance to Elton John. I wish I could show it to you. You would agree with me immediately. He's wearing glasses. They're not outrageous or flamboyant glasses, but maybe that contributes to the, they're just little wire-rimmed spectacles, but maybe that contributes to the resemblance. I'm not sure. Hobart was an amazing churchman, and about him, I'll just read you a little bit that one of his contemporaries wrote about him. Under Hobart, the whole tune toward the church changed. It was no longer tolerated as an amply endowed institution to be too respectable to be disturbed, but too torpid to be feared. It was to become a living factor, dreaded by some, admired by others, but acknowledged and respected by all. Hobart made the church in New York a living power. And writing about him, one of his biographers says this: he was warm, pious, zealous, brusque, often irritable, domineering, and extremely energetic. So you can imagine that I liked him a great deal. I don't know if it was Hobart who was responsible for the motto of the General Seminary in New York, but the motto is a Latin version of a phrase from the passage of John's Gospel, the high priestly prayer that we heard in chapter 17 of John's Gospel just now. The motto is Sermo tuus veritas est, thy word is truth. Like so much else about the General Seminary, about the church in general, of course, this motto is deeply outmoded, isn't it? The idea that we could talk about truth in objective terms seems like such a feature of thought and discussion of yesteryear. And yet, Jesus' prayer to God, his Father, suggests perhaps that we should not abandon the idea of truth as an objective reality quite so easily. Do you hear what Jesus says in his prayer? He asks the Father to sanctify them, sanctify his followers, sanctify his church. By extension, I believe this prayer is intended for us. Sanctify us by the truth. Sanctify them in the truth, he says. Thy word is truth. What on earth does that mean in a world where you're supposed to have your truth and I'm supposed to have my truth? And when we say those things, we're supposed to take each other seriously. You've got to live your truth, Bob. You've got to live your truth, Gabby. You've got to live your truth, Susan. I've got to be faithful to my truth, haven't I? John Henry Hobart, I'm pretty sure, would have had none of it, frankly. And he'd have sent you back to the classroom, I assume. He'd have certainly sent you back to Jesus' high priestly prayer. You cannot be sanctified in your truth or my truth. You can only be sanctified in the truth. And there is only one truth. God's word is truth. When Jesus said God's word is truth, he did not mean that we should then make an idol of the Bible, because it didn't exist as we know it yet, of course. When Jesus said, thy word is truth, he was saying something profoundly different and profoundly timeless. What is possible that Jesus was saying when he prayed to Jesus, when he prayed to the Father, thy word is truth, that when God said, I am who I am, I will be who I will be, it was true. And it remains true now. Of the many things that can be said or claimed, about which we could, the veracity of which we could argue, about that there is no argument. Jesus, I think, meant in this prayer, I am who I am. I will be who I will be. When Moses asked God, who shall I tell the people who I talk with, when they asked me, who told me this? He said, I am. Tell them I am sent you. That was true. That was true. When Jesus says, I am the light of the world. I am the vine. I am the gate. I am the good shepherd. It's true when Jesus says those things. For his word is truth. God's word is truth. And Christ himself is God's word. When Jesus hung on the cross and said, weak from his ordeal there, it is finished. It was true. That God's work of salvation, which would still remain to be unfolded, as even as it remains to be unfolded now, was finished then and there. God's work of salvation was sealed by Christ's death on the cross. It was true when Jesus said, it is finished. Hobart was just a man with lots of flaws like any of us. But he knew something about the truth of God and the truth of the power of Jesus. And if the church became a living power in New York under Hobart's leadership, it was less because of Hobart than it was because of the truth. And if we have a ministry that has anything to do with Hobart's ministry, it's to help the world see again the truth. And to encourage people to understand the truth that God is who God is. God will be who God will be. That Christ is himself the good shepherd and the light of the world and the vine of which we are the branches and the gate through which we must all pass. These things are true. Much else in the world is not true. Much of what's spoken is not true. In a world of nothing but noise and words, it's more important than ever to be able to sift the truth from that which is not true. And Jesus taught us how to do that when he allowed us to hear him pray to his Father, his desire that you and I should be sanctified, made holy, joined to him in our holiness, in truth, and that God's word is truth. May we ever hold fast to that truth. May we remember what is true and what is not. And may Christ's prayer continue to be at work in our lives, that we may indeed be sanctified by the truth.
Now let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church and the world. Almighty and ever-living God, who in thy holy word has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, and Daniel, our bishop, and Nora, Stephen, Nicholas, and Gordon, my priest brothers and sisters who worship and work in this place and parish, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and truly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. We beseech thee also so to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of governments in this and in every land, especially Donald, our president, the members of the Congress and the courts, Tom, our governor, and Jim, our mayor, and all those in positions of authority and public trust during these days of pandemic and protest, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that rejoicing in thy whole creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy body. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and suffer all those who are sick with the coronavirus, doctors, nurses, medical workers of all kinds, and essential workers of various occupations who put themselves at risk for the well-being of others, all those who are unemployed and are worried about their livelihoods, their careers, their families, and their well-being, all those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, who are struggling for justice that's been denied, and are working to bring about an end to the sin of racism in our hearts and in our society, all those who are endangered by fires in the West, and especially those who are fighting the fires, that they may be protected and kept safe, and all those who are beloved of this parish community, who are sick or in need of any kind, especially remembering to pray for Chris, George, Sue, Tom, Kent John, George, John, Tim, Homer, Mary Jane, Marlene, Mark, Richard, Suzanne, Will, Kathy, Paul, Sarah, Lee, Jan, Jean, T.R., Armand, Bill, Janet, Mike, Julie, Larry, Susan, Tucker, and all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially all those who died from the coronavirus in the past day, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to grant us grace, so to follow the good examples of the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, of Blessed Mark, the Evangelist, of Blessed John Henry Hobart, and of all thy saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with heart of repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Of your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Of your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord receive this sacrifice at my hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both for our good and for that of all his holy Church. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God, for the wonderful grace and virtue declared in all thy saints, who have been the chosen vessels of thy grace and the lights of the world in their generation. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice
oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. Humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy for our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
perfectly sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may ever dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that takest away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ, the bread. all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God.